garden. He continues to call for each one to join his caring family. Our choir, drawn by the 10 stations, will now present our tribute to Edmund.
Thank you. So I won't take any much longer. I still have my, I remember my team that we worked with, Mrs. Devna, Mrs. Gable, I don't think she's here, Mr. McDonald, whom I can never forget. I think the music is still the same, it really sounds wonderful. So, and I must compliment the amount of parents that have come. Please, thank you so much for coming and encouraging your children. Okay, without much ado, we'll start off with the results for class 4. And do we have the students? Do we have the students? Okay, we have all the class representatives. So, we start with class 4. The third position in class 4 goes to class 4E. Give a round of applause. The second position goes to 4D, D for Delhi. And the first position, any guesses, boys?
4A.
You sure it's 4A?
Yes.
Class 4A. Thank you, Pujala. Thank you, Akasha. Can we have Mrs. Sheel and our chief guest to do the honors? Class 5. The third position goes to class 5D, D for Delhi. Congratulations, 5D. The second position goes to 5B, B for Bombay. And the first position, I don't think we need to think much about it. It's the best I've heard for that past 1 hour. 5E. Congratulations, 5E.
Good morning, Brother Miranda, Principal of St. Columba School. This is Sangeeta Sheen, Headmistress of the Middle School. I feel quite honored to come here as the chief guest this morning. And I must say that as I heard the poems and the songs, I would see a lot of creativity and talent bursting from every boy who recited the poem and sang the song. I could see the classics come alive over here. You know, parents, today, a lot of time is spent on things like, you know, things which pass very quickly, but to learn a poem, to learn a song, is something which will always remain with your words. And I think, I feel so happy that these kids were encouraged to learn some classics which will live in their hearts forever. We all were students, and I remember when I was a student, all that I remember today is how my English teacher taught me to recite poems. And I think this is what will remain. And you know, boys, all of you who are seated here with prizes in your hands, and all those who have not won prizes, the biggest prize today that all of you have received is coming on stage and facing the audience. It's not easy to face the audience, and also congratulate all the teachers who have taught them these poems. I think you will vouch what I say. To train one kid is not that easy, but to train so many children and so perfectly is something out of this world. I think the teachers really deserve a huge round of applause. Thank you for inviting us,
parents, dear students. Won't take up much of your time. We've had such lovely poem and recitation that I would be an absolute failure in competing with my young lads. But all I want to say is, on behalf of the principal who's engaged just now, a lot of hard work goes behind this, parents. As sister said, we care. We as a nation, as parent body, not just in Columbus, but we are the present generation that has to prepare the next generation. And that lies with us. We are committed to language development. This is a classic example of our efforts towards developing the language, which does not come easily. So, while we all face challenges in life, but what we have to focus on is that if we educate our children well, we as a nation will be able to progress. So I invite you all into a partnership of joining us and being a part of the growth of your children. Thank you once again for being here. It was lovely having you here, and I'm telling you, your children were the happiest seeing their parents, each one looking to see whether his parent was there, and that makes a difference. Everything else is secondary. Thank you. God bless each one of you. And once again, I think the credit goes to the whole team. Without it, these boys wouldn't be here. Thank you so much. God bless you.
Thank you, Prakash. I wouldn't take long. No celebration comes to an end without a vote of thanks. Firstly, I thank you, dear parents, for being here to motivate and appreciate your children who are so dear to us. I thank all our dear students of classes 4 and 5 for making a great effort to do their best today and making this commemoration of our founder, Blessed Edmund Rice, so wonderful. I thank each and every English teacher who has so painstakingly
trust us.